من التزم السلفية حصل الخير كله وحصل أجرا عظيما وفيرا كبيرا، لأنه لزم هدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
طيب السؤال يقول يا شيخنا، السؤال ده خاص بالمحارم، يقول A brother is asking am I considered to be a mahram from my uncle's wife. فالسؤال يقول يا شيخنا، هل أنا أعتبر محرم لزوجة عمي أو زوجة خالي؟ لأن كلمة أنكل عندهم في اللغة الإنجليزية شيخنا غير محددة إلا إذا أضافوا إليها كلمة أخرى، فجايز يكون الخال أو العم في الحالة هذه.
المحرم هو من تحرم عليه على التأبيد، من تحرم عليه المرأة على التأبيد، والذي تحرم عليه على التأبيد هي الأم والبنت والأخت والخالة والعمة والأخت من الرضاعة والأم من الرضاعة وهذه وأم الزوجة، هذه من المحرمات، وزوجة الأب، وزوجة الأب هذه من المحرمات على التأبيد،
وزوجة الابن يا شيخ،
وزوجة الابن نعم وزوجة الابن هذه محرمة على التأبيد، هذا هو يكون محرم. أما الذي تكون محرمة مؤقتة كزوجة الخال أو زوجة العم فهذا ليس محرم عليها، بل لو طلقها خاله أو عمه طلق زوجته فله، وليس بينهم يعني ما يحرم الزواج من غير هذه يعني من غير هذه الصلة، فيجوز له أن يتزوجها بعد وفاة خاله أو بعد طلاقه لزوجه. نعم، فالمحارم المحرم هو الذي تحرم عليه المرأة على التأبيد، هذا هو الذي يكون محرم. نعم
شيخنا، ممكن نضيف إلى التحريم المؤقت زوجة الأخ أيضا؟
أي نعم، زوجة الأخ نعم بلا شك، وكل مرأة يعني وأخت الزوجة إذا أنت تريدها تنفك، وأخت الزوجة أيضا المحرم المؤقت، هذا محرم مؤقت. نعم، لو طلق زوجته وانتهت عدتها حلت له أختها.
So in answering this question, المحرم as the Sheikh said in definition is the one that is prohibited upon him to marry that woman forever, for eternity. Again, المحرم is the one that is prohibited upon him to marry a particular woman. In other words, he can be a mahram for a woman that's prohibited upon him to marry her forever. And they go in the order of those who are prohibited upon you to marry forever, starting with the mother, the daughter, the sister, the maternal aunt, and the paternal aunt, also your sister by breastfeeding, and your mother who breastfed you, or your mother from breastfeeding. Also, the mother of the wife, as well as the wife of your father, as well as the wife of your son. All of these become prohibited upon you as a Muslim man to marry for eternity, if they happen to be from one of those classifications, if you want to call it, or one of those relatives. That is the permanent, if you want to call it, mahram. As for what we may refer to as a temporary mahram, which means a woman that you can marry once she is disconnected from a particular relative of yours. And to define that better, a temporary prohibition upon you to marry, for example, is the wife of your uncle on your father's side, as well as the wife of your uncle on your mother's side. But if your uncle, for example, maternal or paternal, divorces that woman, after her iddah, it's permissible for you to marry her if you wanted to marry her, if there is no other prohibitions according to the Sharia to prevent you from marrying her. And as I asked the Sheikh a couple of times here, just for the sake of clarity, as an added benefit, also the wife of your brother or your sister-in-law, as we say in English, as well as the sister of your wife. Both are classified as sister-in-law, unfortunately, in English. And this is why we're trying to be more particular. The wife of your brother is prohibited upon you temporarily unless she's divorced from your brother. And after her iddah, again, if there's no other prohibitions, according to the Sharia, you can marry the wife of your brother. The same goes for the sister of your wife. And these are temporary mahrams, if you want to call it that, or prohibited temporarily, and you cannot be a mahram for them. You cannot be for any of those temporary classifications as a mahram, as a man. So again, the true definition of a mahram is the one that is prohibited upon you to marry from amongst the women folk forever, that we mentioned earlier in the answer. And those, of course, are the ones you can be a mahram for, the ones that have the permanent prohibition upon you to marry.